Tonight, reports of hundreds of Sri Lankan asylum seekers boarding boats set for Australia, stoking a fear that has dominated our national politics for decades. Hunkered down in a fishing trawler, asylum seekers desperately trying to make it to Australia, intercepted by the Sri Lankan Navy.
We know this is not the legal route, but we're risking the lives of our children because we have no other choice.
In the last few weeks, more than 300 Sri Lankans have reportedly tried to get to Australia in boats as the country's economic crisis spirals.
We are concerned that this could develop into a full-blown humanitarian emergency. Nearly 5.7 million people are in need of humanitarian assistance.
A nation already bankrupt, on the verge of economic collapse, running out of petrol, medicines and food, with months of blackouts.
Without gas, we can't do anything. Without kerosene oil, we can't do anything. Lot of people died.
On the day of our federal election, Border Force confirmed a boat did make it to Australian waters, but was intercepted.
I've been here to stop this boat, but in order for me to be there to stop those that may come from here, you need to vote Liberal and Nationals today.
That boat, the subject of a mass text message sent out to voters by the Liberal Party. Keep our borders secure by voting Liberal today, the text read.
The text message to millions of Australians in breach of the government's own policy helped to undermine Operation Sovereign Borders.
People smugglers are now reportedly promising desperate Sri Lankans they'll be allowed into Australia under the new Labor government.
People say if you go to Australia, you can make a happy life and get citizenship.
During the previous Labor government, 50,000 people journeyed to Australia by boat. At least 1,200 died at sea. Labor saying today it is sticking with the Morrison government's boat turnback policy.
People will not be coming to Australia by boat. We will continue the take-back operations and we will continue them without hesitation. That is actually what has occurred over the last few weeks.
A decade ago, Sri Lankan asylum seekers arriving here were largely fleeing ethnic-based persecution in the aftermath of a civil war. So is a new crisis in Sri Lanka now about to reignite Australia's most divisive political issue?
Well, Chris Barrett is the Southeast Asia correspondent for the Sydney Morning Herald. He spoke to the 12 people on the boat intercepted by Border Force on the morning of the Australian election. So, Chris, was the election a factor then at all in their decision to make the journey when they did?
Well, it wasn't a factor in that particular boat. Those guys who I spoke to a couple of weeks ago, they told me they had no idea there was actually an election on, and they didn't pay people smugglers either, which is, I suppose, is a bit of an outlier in the situation with boat people trying to make their way to Australia. And one thing, though, they said, though, was that they truly believed that they would get into Australia due to the situation with the economic crisis going on in Sri Lanka at the moment, that Australia would have mercy in a way and allow them in. And they didn't want to make up stories about being persecuted, you know, for ethnic reasons. There simply would be economic migrants trying to escape a pretty terrible situation in their own country.
Is there any evidence that people smugglers, though, are luring people onto boats because there's been a change of government in Australia?
Well, Hamish, certainly the Sri Lankan Navy think that's the case. I think there's two things at play here. Clearly, there's the economic collapse. According to the Navy and according to people on the ground, people smugglers are using that situation to try and manipulate the vulnerable, to try and take advantage of the situation and use it as a recruitment tool. And you know, it seems to be working in some way. Those boats that have got close to Australia, keep in mind they're smaller trawlers with 12 to 15 people on them. The people smuggling ones are the ones that have been pulled up by the Sri Lankan Navy with, you know, 50 or more people on board, really crammed on bigger boats. So, I think they are probably using it to test this new Labor government out, but clearly, you know, Labor's said that it's not going to change its stance, so potentially the message will get through eventually.
Just to pick you up on that point, Chris, what are, like, on the ground in Sri Lanka, how strong is that message? And if you try to come by boat to Australia, it just won't happen. Obviously, the people smugglers are trying to, you know, work their angle, but for the day-to-day people, how strong is that message?
It can't be too strong because, the guys I spoke to in the house of one of their parents, and they're all mates and family members, they truly believed they would get in. What the Australian government has done in Sri Lanka, but in other countries as well, like Indonesia, is run a campaign called Zero Chance, where they go to the level of distributing playing cards to to kids with little messages on them about the fact that you can't travel to Australia by sea. They've run film competitions where they get budding filmmakers to try and make clips about explaining the perils of such a journey. So they have been quite active in this space, but there are other forces, I guess, pushing back. I suppose the real question is whether they'll come in greater numbers now, because the success rate is zero. So eventually you would imagine that message is going to get through and be reinforced.
Chris, thanks for your time tonight.
Thanks for having me.